Guns continue to boom across India and Pakistan border in Kashmir. For the fifth day running, Pakistan violated ceasefire in the Jammu region on Tuesday. These are visuals of the damage caused in the Arispura and Arnia sector. At least six people are reportedly injured in the shelling, which has been on since last Friday. Hundreds of villages along the border have been deserted due to the non-stop shelling. Schools in a 5-kilometer radius have been closed. People have been evacuated. Meanwhile, India has decided to send a delegation to Pakistan to participate in the anti-terrorism conference being held in Islamabad. Yes, you heard it right. An anti-terrorism conference in Islamabad, and India is participating. The 3-day conference is being held under the banner of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Pakistan had joined the organization in 2017, and this is the first time that Islamabad is hosting the event. Legal experts from 8 member states of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization regional anti-terrorist structure will meet from Wednesday. Apart from China, India and Pakistan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan and Uzbekistan are members of the organization.
We are fighting the war. If the military aid starts to degrade our efforts to fight the war on terrorism.
And on this, I'm joined by my colleague Aisha Sindhu from Newsroom. Aisha, tell me, isn't it ironical that when hard positions are taken domestically and somehow you have to meet those multilateral commitments, it becomes totally, or I would say very, very difficult for any political dispensation to reconcile the sort of domestic feelings, which are far more tuned to the internal political affairs. But on the other hand, you have these commitments.
Right. I'll pick up from that word ironic that you use, Karthik, here, because there are multiple ironies at play over here. Let's not forget that Pakistan, of all the countries, is choosing to host this dialogue on peace, and India is participating, of course, under the aegis of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, which both countries have recently become members of. In addition, just shortly earlier this week, Pakistan was the one that pled with India, asking for a ceasefire along the line of control because it suffered heavy casualties, and now it's responded in this manner, causing untold damage on the Indian side of the border. This is also the holy month of Ramzan, and it just goes to show that there is, when it comes to hostilities between India and Pakistan, it seems that only one country is willing to keep up its end of the bargain and play the bigger brother role, if you will, in this partnership, and that is clearly India. An 8-month-old infant was one of the victims in this latest ceasefire violation. So it just goes to show the level to which Pakistan has dropped, when it comes to engagement between India and Pakistan, specifically, of course, along the line of control.
Thank you, Aisha. Thank you for this update. So my colleague Aisha Sindhu telling us, yes, the irony is the fact that the Indian official will be there tomorrow. But the fact of the matter is that there's a ceasefire violation which is taking place at the international border. A lot of people have died, a lot of civilians have died.